have. Yeah, this one says that we have x squared plus x minus 20 for numerator. Denominator is x squared plus 2 times x minus 1. Okay. This one, again, is different from previous one. You see, we have x plus 2 for the first quantity, and here the degree is 2. Once you have a degree, here is 2x plus 2. Upstairs, you cannot just write one constant, okay? It has to be degree 1 less than the denominator. You see, here is 1. So the reason, again, we are doing so to write ax plus b is because here the degree down on denominator is 2. That's why the degree of numerator has to be 1. And here it has x minus 1. So then the degree will be 1 less than the denominator x minus 1. So then c has to be a constant. Okay. So the partial fraction decomposition has to be in this way. All right. Now, in order to add those two together, x squared plus 2 needs to have a x minus 1, because here it has x minus 1. So the first fraction needs to multiply by x minus 1 on both numerator and denominator. The second fraction needs to multiply by x squared plus 2 and x squared plus 2. Okay, so in this way you will get x squared plus 2 times x minus 1 here for the first fraction. The second one, x minus 1 multiplied by x squared plus 2. So they are the same, they will have the same denominators now. Okay, now again, for the numerator here, you got to FOIL this one out. AX times X is AX squared. That's first term. Okay, outer term is negative 1 times AX, so it's negative AX. And the inside is B times X, that's BX. And the last one is negative 1 times B, so it's negative B. Okay, you FOIL this one out. And here C used the distributive property. So you have a C times X squared is CX squared. And here C times 2 is 2C. That's numerators. Okay, now you got to add those two together. X squared. So you pull X squared out, you have A plus C for the coefficient. And here the second one does not have an x. So here is negative ax, here is bx. So you got to put those two together. Okay? You pull x out, then you have a negative a, and here you have a positive b. Now, negative b with 2c, then it's negative b plus 2c. This would be the constant part. Okay, we know, again, x squared has to be 1, because here the coefficient of x squared is 1. So a plus c is 1. A plus c is 1. First equation. Negative a plus b is also 1, because here the coefficient of x is 1. So negative a plus b is 1. Okay. And this is the constant part. So negative b plus 2c has to be negative 20. Negative b plus 2c is negative 20. So we are ready to solve this one. I'll leave the details for you. And we'll find out the solution. A is 7. B is 6. C is negative. B is 8. C is negative 6. Okay. Then you can put it back. A positive 7, Okay, B is 8, and C is negative 6. That's the fraction. Fraction decomposition for this one. Okay, this one, you try yourself. Again, here is the hint. Okay. Step 1, factor this one. Pull x out. And then only 1 x is out, you have x squared. 2x, 1 x is out here, you have a 2 here. So you see x squared plus 2. It's like this one. Okay. So since it's like this one, the numerator you should have ax plus b. So again, here you see the exponent is 1. So then that's why here you have a constant, a, without any x. But x squared plus 2, the degree is 2, so upstairs, the polynomial, the degree of the polynomial has to be 1. Okay? So, then you want to add those two fractions together. The first one is x squared plus 2, because it has only, it has in the second fraction. The second one is x. Then in this way, it will get the common denominator x times x squared plus 2. Okay, so a times x squared is ax squared. A times 2 is 2a. And here is the same. X times bx, so is bx squared. C times x is cx. You have ax squared and bx squared. Pull x squared out, you have a plus b. And here 2a plus, 2a is right here. Cx is that. You cannot put those two together, because here it does not have x. So again, the coefficient of x squared is a plus b, and here is 10, so a plus b is 10. C is the coefficient of x, then comparing that, we got c is negative 5, and we got 2a has to be 6. So a must be 3. C must be negative 5, and if you plug in back here, then you know, what do we get? A is 3, so 3 plus B is 10, B has to be 7. So we then have A, 3, B, 7, C, negative 5. You put it back here, A is 3, okay, 3 over X, and B is 7x minus C is negative 5, so you have a minus 5 here. Okay, please review this lecture. I'll see you next time.